Yes, dear children, so this is the topic that we have been seeing. Okay, yesterday also I sent you so many videos based on this so that you can visualize things and you can understand it much better. Okay, so let me again repeat that. It's a very, very important topic. Lee-Chatelier principle. When a system or reaction at equilibrium is subjected to change, either in terms of concentration or pressure or volume or temperature, or something, some inert gas is added to it, it may be in any form, then the system readjusts itself to counteract the effect of change caused to it. Okay, so this is the principle. Okay, and you have to learn the principle. You cannot write the way you want. Okay, it has to be very clear. The system readjusts itself to counteract the effect of change caused to it. Now, let me give you an example. Say, for example, we are considering nitrogen plus 3 hydrogen giving you 2 ammonia. Okay. Now, what I'm doing, I'm making this ammonia escape from the system, from the medium. See, in an equilibrium, all the 3 will be present, is it not? So, if I make ammonia, if I collect ammonia by opening up the container and removing some amount of ammonia, then what the system will do? The system will immediately understand hamare andar NH3 ki kami hai, hame banana padega. So the shift of equilibrium will be towards the right. Okay, so ammonia which you have removed, that amount of ammonia will be replenished. That means the system will move in the forward direction. Okay. Now, if I am removing, say, hydrogen, then immediately the system will realize that there is insufficient hydrogen in the medium, so I have to produce. So, what will happen? The system will start moving in the backward direction so that hydrogen is produced, and again the system comes back to a new equilibrium state. Now, supposing if I add hydrogen, if I remove hydrogen, the system is moving in the backward. If I add extra hydrogen, then what will happen? Then immediately the system will understand that I have to consume. I am getting more. I have to consume it fast. Okay. So again, the system will move in the forward direction. Right? If I add ammonia, what will happen? Then the system will immediately recognize that more and more of ammonia is produced. It is not needed. So I have to move to produce more and more of nitrogen and hydrogen. So it will move in the backward direction. So anything that is present in excess will be consumed. So consumption mein jis direction mein jana hai, us direction mein jayega. And if there is any deficiency, say if I have removed hydrogen, the system will start producing it. Okay. So jahan pe insufficiency hai, wahan pe produce hoga. Jahan pe excess hai, wo consume hoga. तो कंज्यूम कैसे होगा? नाइट्रोजन और हाइड्रोजन ही कंबाइन करेंगे ना, तो रिएक्शन विल मूव इन द फॉरवर्ड डायरेक्शन. इज दैट क्लियर? सो दिस इज व्हाट यू हैव टू अंडरस्टैंड इन टर्म्स ऑफ कंसंट्रेशन. नाउ द सेम रिएक्शन, इट इज एन एक्सोथर्मिक प्रोसेस. द फॉरवर्ड रिएक्शन इज एक्सोथर्मिक, सो एनर्जी इज रिलीज. सम 92 किलो जूल ऑफ एनर्जी और समथिंग इज रिलीज, वॉट एवर बी द एनर्जी. नाउ यू नो दैट इट इज एन एक्सोथर्मिक रिएक्शन. नाउ व्हाट विल हैपन इफ आई एम गोइंग टू increase the temperature of the system. Okay, the system is removing energy in the forward direction. Okay, for the forward reaction to take place, so energy is not needed. So if I'm supplying temperature, if I'm supplying energy, then what will happen? Energy requiring process will start moving. Which is the energy requiring process? Backward, because ammonia plus energy only will decompose to give you these two. So the increase in temperature will shift the direction of reaction in the backward direction. Now, supposing if I make it low temperature, then what will happen? If it is low temperature, if the temperature is lowered, then the system will move in the forward direction. But if the temperature is raised, then the system will move in the backward direction. Is that clear? Now, let us come to pressure. Now, if I am increasing the pressure of the system, remember one thing, all 3 are there in the same container so long as the container is closed. Okay. So, if I am going to increase the pressure of the system, then what will happen? Nitrogen and hydrogen will collide with each other more frequently. If they collide more and more frequently, what will happen? It will form ammonia. Okay, so try to remember, increase in pressure will make the direction of reaction towards lesser number of moles. This side you are having 2 moles, this side you are having 3 plus 1, 4. So increase in pressure will shift the equilibrium towards that position where there are lesser number of moles. So increase in pressure will shift it in the forward direction, whereas decrease in pressure will shift it in the backward direction. Is that clear? So this is the basic thing that you have to understand in this particular concept.